You're looking at a memory of Christmas past, a snapshot taken with film. But the film in question, Kodachrome, is itself about to become a memory. Our cover story is reported now by Jim Axelrod.
Find a hole through there, Randy, someplace on the back.
Photographer Kent Miller is up before sunrise to make sure everything's perfect for his shoot.
Perfect.
He wants to capture a triathlete named Carlos Lima at the foot of the George Washington Bridge, just across the river from Manhattan, in just the right light at dawn.
This was a great opportunity to photograph him in a really, really special way. Body facing that way, so, and then spin the bike around a little bit more and drop the front.
A professional photographer for more than 20 years, Kent shoots mostly digital now.
You can't see the picture.
But this is a job for film.
Yeah, there we go, now we got it. Gotta love the sound of a film camera.
Not just any film, Kodachrome.
Yeah, load it up. It just reproduces colors in a way that most other films never did, and it lasts forever. Something that's difficult to do with just shooting digital until you bring it into Photoshop and then you saturate and do all your work in there. But just straight out the camera, it doesn't have that density and that dynamic ranges as the Kodachrome does just naturally. Love it.
The shoot goes great.
Beautiful, Carlos, beautiful.
But it's a poignant day for Kent Miller, because these rolls of Kodachrome are the last rolls he'll ever shoot.
I've just been saving it for a special time, and this is the special time.
For 75 years, Kodachrome has given millions of us those nice bright colors. The first mass marketed color film. It was popular enough not just to inspire its own song, but have a state park in Utah named after it as well. The film of choice for professionals documenting history. As well as generations of amateurs preserving their most treasured memories.
I honestly don't have those numbers.
Todd Gustafson is the curator of technology at the Eastman House, Kodak's museum in Rochester, New York.
It's a baby boom product. After World War II, availability of new automobiles, national parks were open, people were able to actually have some time to travel, and of course now there's this new color film which you could use to document your family vacations, and then of course come back and show your friends and neighbors your slides on your carousel or actually your Kodak slide projector.
You remember times of your life.
But technology caught up to Kodachrome. In a digital world, there was no longer enough demand for Kodak to keep making the film. And even if you have a roll squirreled away, after this coming Friday, December 30th, you or Kent Miller or anyone else won't be able to get it developed.
Because on December 30th, Dwayne's photo, right here in Parsons, Kansas, will stop processing Kodachrome. So what, you say? You'll just take yours somewhere else? No, you won't.
Maybe the best person to explain is Dwayne Steinle himself, who started the business 56 years ago.
There's not going to be any place left to process it.
No place in the world left to process it. We're the very last in the world, on the entire planet.
On December 30th,
Dwayne's son, Grant, runs things now.
We're going to be running our last rolls of film on December 30th, and then we'll retire this piece of equipment.
And Kodachrome isn't a do-it-yourself kind of film. Those long-lasting, brilliant colors are the result of a unique developing process involving special chemicals only Kodak makes, or made, to be precise.
And Kodachrome's nothing you can develop in your basement dark room.
No. The real difference between Kodachrome and all the other color films is that the dyes that make up the image you see in the film in Kodachrome don't get incorporated into the film until it's actually developed.
They're still doing 700 rolls a day at Duane's from all over the world, but they only have enough chemicals to last another week.
As you get closer to the 30th, is part of you feeling nostalgic, poignant?
Oh, sure. It's going to be a really sad day. I mean, it was an important part of our business, and Kodachrome was an important part of the history of all of photography. You know, it was the first consumer color film that was available. Lots of really iconic images of the 20th century were captured on Kodachrome.
Steve McCurry captured one. The 12-year-old Afghan girl on the cover of National Geographic in 1984.
This is incredible.
Yeah.
Actually, he captured two when he went back and found her 17 years later. Both were shot on Kodachrome.
This was probably the greatest film that was ever made.
No other film in the world could have done this?
No, I don't think so, no.
When Kodak announced it was discontinuing Kodachrome last year, Steve McCurry had an idea.
So I called my contacts, my friends at Kodak, and said, you know, I'd really like to get the last roll and do a project with it to kind of honor this passing of this iconic film.
Over the years, Steve McCurry had spent lots of time taking pictures in India. He had the perfect subjects in mind.
It was a nomadic community which I spent a week with and traveled with them and photographed their way of life. Because again, like Kodachrome, their way of life is vanishing.
He used most of the last roll of Kodachrome ever produced, but saved just a couple of frames, which he shot in Parsons, just before dropping the film off at Duane's.
This is the very last
image
you make with Kodachrome?
Yeah, this is actually a Civil War cemetery in Parsons, Kansas. And I drove past the cemetery and I thought this would be a perfect kind of ending to the role of Kodachrome. I mean, a cemetery is a passing of an era.
Progress is defined as an advancement or improvement. But in some ways, it's hard to see how a world without Kodachrome qualifies as either.
Ahead, 'tis the season.